Hello champions, welcome to another episode of Risk. Today we are playing another 6 player Trix card game which is being played with intermediate plus rank players. And judging by my troop setup, the most sense for me would make to go for Europe guys. This is why I'm going to add my troops right here guys. On the other hand, the white player has a lot of troops near this area as well, so I'm not sure about white. Maybe the white player is going to contest for Europe with me as well. Not sure guys, we are going to see. But alright, the purple player unexpectedly adds his troops in Europe as I thought that he was really going to go for Australia since he has the most of troops in it. On the other hand, he maybe doesn't want to go to risk for it as there are 5 troops on Siam of the black player. And the black player is the last player in this turn, so he is going to receive even 6 troops in his turn. Alright, what player added his troops in Europe, so will he be going for the same continent as well? Or I mean, I could potentially move into Africa, guys. I think I will potentially move into Africa. If Europe is contested by the purple and white players, Africa will be the best decision to me. So if a pink player doesn't add his troops in it right here. Alright, the pink player added his troops in Asia. He added his troops in Asia, and let's see if he's going to fortify some more troops in Mongolia, so what he will potentially go for Australia, or will he fortify his army to Kamchatka, so to potentially relocate himself towards going for North America. Alright, as of now, I'm not sure what is he going to do. And the green player sent me alliance request, I assume, because I wouldn't contest with him for South America, but will the black player goes for Africa? No, he fortifies his troops in Siam, which is really good for sure. Alright, and please, green, fortify your troops out from Africa. Right, the pink player wants the alliance quest. Let's accept him. Let's send thumbs up to the green player. I am going to go for Africa, guys. Hopefully that doesn't intimidate the green player, since I do not want to contest for South America with him. All I want is to capture Africa, since Europe will be contested with a purple and white player, so if you want to fight it out for it, then we can fight it out. While meanwhile, I am going to take over Africa. And come on, purple, why don't you move your troops from East Africa? You could have added one more troop and captured the territory of Middle East, fortify those troops in Europe. And alright, this is what I actually going to do right now. And honestly, if a green player attacks the territory of a black player and fortifies his troops in Peru, then I could just move my Venezuelan troops to Africa. This is what I would like to do, guys. I would like to save those troops and what the green player at the same time would need to crush those troops eat. The white player is moving his troops closer to Europe, which I really like a lot, because if the purple and white players fight with each other for Europe, then one of them might be eliminated from the game soon. Or at the best case scenario, both of them will get eliminated, so we will end up in the 4-player situation immediately. And pink player will be without a continent at all. Or I mean, he potentially waits till the black player captures Australia, so then Australia will belong to him. But he will just take Australia from the black player, since the black player will probably waste a lot of troops if he goes capturing Australia immediately. So if I was a black player, then I will be more careful. Please waste your troops in Africa. Yes, move your troops out. Move your troops out. Yes, thank you. Alright, let's tell pink to attack the territory of black. Yes, let's send him thumbs up. Come on, juice. Alright, well, I mean, that's never mind. That's fine, what is he is capturing those troops immediately as well. Let's attack this territory, and hopefully the green player is going to move his troops out from Africa. Send him thumbs up. Also, I've got a 10 troop set, so I could potentially consider capturing Africa immediately if I want. And I might even do that, assuming the green player wastes his troops in South Africa. Also, I'm wondering to see how the conflict goes between the purple and white players. Maybe I should wait a little bit. Maybe I should even wait a little, guys. So basically, the green player captures South America, I'm going for Africa, the purple and white players contesting for Europe, the black player would like to go for Australia, and the pink player would like to take Australia from the black player once he captures it. Or maybe not anymore, because he fortified his troops in Japan. But maybe once the black player takes over Australia, he fortifies those troops back and potentially takes Australia from the black player. But alright, looks like the black player goes for Australia immediately, guys. He goes for Australia immediately. And I mean, should I unleash the pink player's army towards the black player or not, guys? Well, on the other hand, I and the pink player's allies, I'm not sure how much the pink player will appreciate it. And let's tell the green player that I'm sorry, but I need to attack his territory. Well, better wait till he sets his troops, as otherwise he might get the wrong idea. So let's see if he's going to do right here, guys. And alright, he might just... Alright, please don't crush my army. Alright, I was a bit worried. I thought that he might even can crushing my biggest army. And alright, thank you. Honestly, I will trade in a set over here regardless. And should I go for it immediately? I think I will do it, guys. Alright, I lost 3 troops over here, which I do not like too much. Alright, hopefully no OP players invade me, so otherwise it was a bit of the troops waste. But I assume the purple player wants to go for Europe. His priority is to capture Conan for himself, and I assume the black player wouldn't like to waste his troops on me either, since he would like to strengthen his Australian position. So the biggest threat is, honestly for me, is the green player, since he could invade me, and I couldn't really retaliate to him, so unless I would suicide on him. But on the other hand, the green player is my ally. So he might not do it. But let's see what the black player is going to do over here. Hopefully crushes, completely eliminates the purple player. Yes, and that is going to be the case, guys. Yes, GG. Let's tell well played. Let's honestly make the alliance with a white player, since we are going to be neighboring players, so it will be in our best interest to let each other hold content. Yeah, attack my territory if you need to take over Europe. Alright, the green player wants me to attack white. Why green? I will just lose my position. The black player could attack white, and he will be still able to sustain Australian position, but probably not, because the white player is at 5 cards, so he's going to trade in a set, and the black player's army is that low. So I mean, the green player has his troops in Irkutsk, so he could definitely invade the white player into Ukraine if he wants. And come on, black, don't you dare to invade me, but you could invade the white player if you want. Alright, just move troops out from North America. And with that, the only person who could invade me and prevent me from getting troop bonuses is the green player, which told me to attack white, but isn't going to invade him by himself. On the other hand, I didn't send him thumbs up, so I understand that why it might be the case. So that's fine also. And as you can see, the green player is showing me a strong alliance by not guarding any troops against my border. He doesn't guard Brazil, guys. Let's see where the white player is going to add his troops to, and I assume he is going to fortify his troops out from North America. And honestly, the black and pink players are weak players in this game, so we could be potentially eliminated from the game, but it will be good, right? Their secondary armies will be crushed. And so otherwise, I do not really think I will going to eliminate. Looking at this counter, we still have a lot of troops, and the pink player trades in a 10 troop set enemy. Let's see what is he going to do here. Is he going to go for North America, or he will fortify his troops out from to Japan, to use the Japanese turtle strategy, guys. Alright, the black player doesn't seem to have a set. If I want, I could potentially try eliminating the black player, but he is at 28 troops, so I will just lose a bunch of troops, even if I succeed, and with that, game will be lost to me. I will probably be eliminated from the game next, so I'm not going to do that. Also, I do not really like what the white player has the biggest army over here. Hopefully he doesn't feel too much threat. We are going to see. I'm just building my army over here, so just to be more accessible to attack other territories, but I mean, I could just fortify that army to use tougher. So I think this is what I might do in the next turn. Also, as you can see, I'm attacking the territories of the pink player, since the pink player is the weakest player, so I would like that he will be eliminated from the game. So yeah, I don't really think it's worth attack the territories of a white player, since he is the strongest player enemy. But I mean, probably nobody is going to eliminate the pink player either way. And the black player gets to survive and trade in asset. The black player trades in asset. Let's see what is he going to over here. Hopefully he doesn't invade. Alright, he just moves his troops out. So honestly, fortify that army over here, so I wouldn't bother the white player. Let's honestly send the thumbs up the white player, so to show him what I appreciate. Alright, he's strengthening his Ukrainian border. And please attack the territory of the pink player, white. You have been attacking the territories of mine. And why are you targeting the territories of mine, white? I thought we were allies. I don't know what the allies are supposed to do, guys. Also, as you can see, I added some more troops right here, so the pink player will later go through Irkutsk. Or we'll just add his troops elsewhere and will attack with his main army. Alright, so the pink player adds troops in North America. Alright, so honestly, the North American continent is uncontested right now. Alright, I do have a 10 troop set, so I think I'm going to trade it in immediately right here. Honestly, I'm wondering to see if the green player eventually expands into North America.
America.
Maybe he will bring the attention towards himself, or maybe he will get strong enough to do something. Let's read in a set. Let's send my troops to this army. This time I'm not going to capture Middle East, so to not block my army. So what it will be able? It will be suitable to go into multiple different directions, guys. Honestly, I think it will be good if the game player's troops were crushed, were removed from Asia. I would really like that a lot for sure, guys. Since when the green player was forced to attack the territories in North America? Right, he ceased to attack my territory. Honestly, I'm not sure what the green player wants to tell me by saying that attack his territory finitas, the only accessible territory to me of the green player is Brazil. So does he want what I will invade him into his continent or something? Maybe he just pressed on his avatar accidentally. Maybe he wanted to tell me to attack some other player or so. Or honestly, if a white player is capturing the territories in North America, so that will be really hilarious if he captures whole North America. If the green player doesn't expand to it or doesn't even capture his territories in it, guys. Alright, so I see the black player is the Australian turtle player. The pink player is a no continent turtle player. The green player is a South American turtle player. I'm the African turtle player. And probably the white player is the most aggressive player in this game. In this game, he might expand to North America. But alright, honestly, the green player goes into it. So, no North America to the white player anymore. Let's capture territory right here. And I've got a wild card, guys. There are only two wild cards in the entire deck, meaning that I have 50% of them. And I think it will be good to save it, so in case of an emergency, I will be able to trade in a set of 3 cards immediately. So I think I'm going to keep it, so unless I see that I'm in danger to not survive. Or otherwise, unless obviously I will be forced to trade in a lower set. Alright, the green player is actually mad for reason after the white player's move. I'm not sure what's that, but I assume that the green player would like that the white player will move out from Greenland. But I'm not too confident that. Black player just moves all of his troops in Indonesia. And alright, let's see if the green player does some. If crashes the army of the white player, but no, he doesn't. So as you can see, me and the green players are not guarding the borders at all. We do that because if our continents get invaded, then we are going to lose just one troop instead of bigger army. So for example, if somebody invades the white player, then the white player is going to lose at the very least 20 troops if somebody goes through the weakest border of him, guys. So because of that reason, I do not split my armies, as nobody is invading me into my borders anyway, and the green player has just sent even more mad emojis. I think the green player doesn't appreciate what the white player doesn't move his army back to Europe. And alright, black player has just still fortifying his troops in Siam, and yes, it's a whole army. He's been taking for a while to do that, so I thought that maybe he's doing the troop split or something, and will the green player do that? Or he just keeps sending those angry face emojis. Alright, I think he's finally doing that, or at least shows what he's more serious. And let's go! Let's go! Yes! Yes, I really like that a lot. The white player's troops were crushed. Alright, the white player wants that I will attack the green player. I do not want the green player. I just want that the white player will attack. Yeah, let's tell him what he could attack my territory. But I mean he goes for it anyway. He understands what he can do it, and I mean I do not mind at all. I really like that. I send him thumbs up. I mean that was really kind of him to ask, but for him to see that he's sorry, but he needs to attack my territory. So yeah, I totally understand the white player. Alright, attack white, the green player sees. I'm not going to attack white, no. I'm not going to attack white. I mean, the green player is really emotional. He makes his moves rationally. Kind of risky to be in the alliance with the green player, as if he gets mad on me in some way, then I think he wouldn't hesitate crushing my troops suiciding into me, from what I will guess. Judging by my experience, by having players who have played similarly. So I'm not going to attack a white player, especially when the white player might even eliminate the green player. I mean, the green player could just invade him by himself. I mean, if he could just add his troops in India and invade the green player into Ukraine, or I mean, he could just even go all the way around. Yeah, he could just even, so this way he will be able to invade the green player into South America as well. And this way we are going to destroy each other, and we are going to end up in the 4-player situation. And honestly, After that, I would like to eliminate the pink player the most, since the pink player is a turtle player. He didn't even show any initiative to go for a continent in the beginning of the game. I think I'm just going to guard my troops right here, so water players will then go through my borders. So what the green and white players will then go through my borders. Or I mean, if one of them goes, then I lose 7 troops. But I think I'm willing to take that risk here. Alright, yeah, the green player might even get eliminated. Let's go. Yes, and I assume water players will go attacking the white player. On the other hand, I'm not sure. Observing the pink and black players' moves, they were really passive. And honestly, I would like to keep the white player in the 3-player situation than anything. And alright, well, that's a bit greedy to the white player to keep his continents, but I mean, if I could potentially take over Europe. Yeah, I could potentially take over Europe, guys. I mean, the pink player showed what he's the most passive player, so the pink player will be my choice to eliminate from the game first, but let's see what the black player does. Alright. The black player is attacking. He is attacking white player, so I think I'm going to eliminate the pink player, guys. If I have a set, yes, I have a wild card, so I think I'm going to eliminate the pink player since he's refusing to play the game. He just wants to stack his troops into one big army in the entire game without even going for a contest. So it will be really hard for me to win the 3-player endgame if he just doesn't do anything. But alright, is the balance of the game being broken, guys? I think honestly, the pink player gets the second place regardless. And the black player suicided on... Well, honestly, even though I want to eliminate the black player from the game first, I cannot really do it, so I'm forced to take out the white player from the game first anyway, and yes, this is what I am going to do, guys. Alright, let's trade in a set. Alright, 4 troops for 100 blitz. And let's eliminate the black player as well. Let's go. Bam. Alright, and I have to protect 3 borders against the pink player. I mean, the pink player made a big mistake by by leaving his troops into a blocked army, I would even say, but I mean, he didn't know that is going to happen. And right here, alright, let's 5 troops, 8 troops here, I want to balance it out, but I mean, 7 troops, yeah, and I'm going to fortify my that army over here. This way, if a pink player doesn't have a set, then I'm going to receive the troops for all of those continents, guys. Let's hope he doesn't have. Alright, well played, the player says, and thanks, the player. It's really amazing that he honestly keeps spectating the game to see who wins. Alright, let's see, alright. 29 troops, guys. Wow, 29 troops. Let's go. And alright, I've got 3 in a set of it. Well played. Thanks. And let's see what kind of good game. Right, thanks, stop it, what? Alright. I mean, honestly, I have to go closer next to that to maximize my chances to win and use manual rolls. Use manual rolls, guys. Let's do those manual rolls before timer out. And let's do here. And I mean, at the end, I'm going to do the blitz. Alright, one more. And let's go. And come on, I cannot click. Wow, guys, I misclicked. I couldn't click on the territory, but I mean, I'm probably winning regardless. So just the pink player could potentially get the attacker's advantage, and he got 11 troops advantage. Wow, guys, that was unfortunate. I should have done the blitz. Just I keep misclicking on those territories, but I'm not sure what the pink player does over here since he just trapped his army right here, guys. Wow, but wow, I almost lost because of a misclick. But I mean, looking at the troops counter, I still had 45 troops anyway. So if you do man rolls, guys, then do not leave the things to the end, because the game could potentially cause that. I mean, I'm not sure who will have won, man. It will have been close if the pink player played properly, if he invaded me into all of my continents. And right here, since the percentage is lower than 50%, I'm just forced to use man rolls. So to potentially get the attacker's advantage, so to maximize the attacker's advantage, I think, yes, I got, and let's do a blitz, alright. No. Alright, let's do this man roll to potentially take over Asia, and yes, I did, guys, and let's fortify my 5 troops over here, and that is going to be a GG for sure. GG, now that's a GG for sure. Wow, guys, I almost messed it up at the end, but at the end, I still won. To be worth 2,500 ranking points, and 406th place on the leaderboard.